This video is a little bit different than others in that we're going to be focusing not just on the to-do list template itself, but on the learning exercises found on the sample sheet, which can be used for learning how to use many or all of your other 150 plus systems to win templates. Now we're going to assume that you already know how to find and open your systems to win templates, because you've already watched the quick start training videos and you've already signed up for a free live webinar. And we're going to assume that you've already completed the self-paced Excel training to quickly learn what you don't know that you don't know about Excel, so you don't get stuck using any systems to win template. If you haven't watched that initial quick start training, then we suggest that you do that first, because you get a lot more out of this if this is a review rather than the first time you've seen this training. Now, if you're saying, gosh, I'm in a hurry, I just don't have time to learn Excel right now, I'm just trying to do a to-do list, that's the reason for this template, the Word version. No bells, no whistles, drop dead simple. But is that where you want to stay? Is that where your employer wants you to stay? If you're in a big hurry, go ahead, get your work done, but then come on back when you're ready to take your professionalism to another level. If you have completed that Excel self-paced learning, you're going to get a lot out of these learning exercises, because you can apply pretty much everything that you learn here to any systems to win template, even if you don't care too much about the to-do list itself. Now we're going to assume that you already know everything there is to know about a help worksheet, because it's organized the exact same way every other systems to win help sheet is organized. We're going to spend all of our time on the sample sheet, where you will find a series of helpful learning exercises. Now, if you speak English well, then you're going to have a much easier time as you complete these learning exercises. But if you are one of our many customers whose native language is something other than English, then you will benefit greatly from watching this training video, because even though most of the help and all of the buttons and all of the column headers are translated, the sample data and the learning exercises are English only. So by watching this video, you'll probably be able to figure things out. Even if your boss didn't follow our advice to provide you with TWI job instructions training to ensure that you'd learn how to use your new tools. So let's get started. The first instruction is to click each column heading and read the pop-up help. So go do that. Pause this video, and then on your template, click each column heading, read and learn about the pop-up help, and when you're done, come back here and press play again. Now the next assignment is to edit that section header. And the whole trick to that is to select that first thin column. And you'll know you've selected the right cell when you see the words in the formula bar, which is where you can do your editing. And then notice that as soon as you hit enter, that whatever you type in the section heading shows up in the table of contents, which is really handy to just click one of these links to quickly go to the top of any section in a long list. And notice that if you're using freeze panes, the table of contents remains visible, so you can quickly move around your long list. If we click the pop-up help for this really thin first column, we see that the purpose of that first thin column is to create fast and easy subheadings. Just type in that first thin column, and there you go, fast, easy subheadings. Now if you want multiple levels of different types of subsections, that's when you use styles. And the whole trick to using styles for subheadings is don't select the whole row, select just those cells you want to format. And then on the Home tab, select the cell styles that you want. And notice if you hover over a style, you can preview what it's going to look like. Let's change it to 2 in head row 3. And if you don't like our colors, you can create your own styles. Now if I've been talking a little too fast for you, I got bad news, because we're about to speed up. Now, I want to remind you, a huge advantage of using training videos is that you can always pause and rewind anything that goes a little too fast and watch it again until you get it. Ready? Here we go. To insert a link icon, first we select the cell, then we select the Systems to Win menu, Insert Link Icon, and then select the type of document that you're linking to. Let's choose the Chinese flag because we're going to link to a document that's written in Chinese. And then we right-click that shape and select the Hyperlink menu. And then link to any related document anywhere on the internet or our internal servers. And there you go. If you make the column wider, you can have unlimited hyperlinks for any line item. So the next assignment is to learn how to personalize drop-down lists. So we follow the link to the training where we can learn how to use drop-down lists, and then we scroll over and do it. Any codes we type here on the DV sheet will also appear here in our drop-down lists. Now, priority codes are just a little bit different in that any priority code that we define that starts with the number 1 will turn the background color of that cell pink, and a 2 will turn it green. So let's make 2 new codes that differentiate between a 1 that's urgent and a 1 that's important. And then back on the sample tab, let's select a priority cell and scroll down the drop-down list and choose one of our new codes. And notice that it will still turn the background color. But notice if we went up to that formula bar and edited it so it no longer starts with the number 1, as soon as we hit the Enter key, watch that pink cell. It's no longer pink. If I type in any code that starts with a 1, that cell is going to turn pink. So it's the same idea for the status code, except that it uses symbols rather than numbers. So if we want another status code that turns yellow, we would copy one of the status codes that already turns yellow and paste it, and then come up to the formula bar and leave that first symbol, but then type some other code after that symbol. Then back on the sample tab, when we select that new code from the drop-down list, it too turns the cell yellow. But if we select a different code from the drop-down list, we get a different result. So our next assignment is to change the format for due date. So let's go look at the pop-up help for that column, which tells us how to do it. Right-click Format Cells Number tab. So let's go do it. Right-click the cell, select the Format Cells menu item. There on the Number tab, we choose a different date format. And there's our date in some other format. Our next assignment is to play with the numbers for effective achievable. You would only use effective achievable analysis if you're choosing between alternatives. Now, you could use the pick matrix template or the quadrant chart to plot out your alternatives on a quadrant matrix, which will plot out each alternative on a scale of effective and achievable. If it's both, then you choose that alternative. If it's one or the other, then maybe you'll consider it. If it's neither effective nor achievable, then you reject that alternative. But sometimes you don't want to take the time to plot that out on a separate chart. You want to just do your effective achievable analysis right there in your to-do list. And our pop-up help tells you what the scale is. Notice that our current rating is a 6 and a 9, which are both above a 5 rating, which puts them in the green upper right quadrant. So if we change effective from a 6 to a 4, and then we press the Enter key, now the color turns yellow because that would put it in the maybe range of the quadrant chart. Pretty neat, isn't it? Now, if you are not choosing between two alternatives, then you're going to want to hide those columns for effective and achievable. Which leads us to our next assignment. If you don't already know how to use Excel to hide rows and columns, follow our online instructions. It's not very difficult. You're just going to select the entire row or column, and then within the blue area that you highlighted, you right-click Hide. Same for a column. Select the entire column, Right-click in the selected blue area, Hide. Now if you insert a row, by selecting the entire row and then right-click Insert, then just be careful because your new row is going to be formatted just like the one above where you inserted. And that may or may not be what you wanted. So let's insert a row here, and notice it'll be formatted just like the row above it. Now on this template, not all templates, but this one, it's okay to use that simple insert method. In fact, if we scroll to the bottom, that's how you'll usually insert a whole bunch of rows at the bottom. It's just the fastest way to do it. But if you want to copy a header row or any row or column in any Excel workbook that has hidden formats or formulas or anything unique, then you don't want to use simple insert rows or columns. You want to learn how to use insert copied cells. Simply copy the entire row or column that you want to copy. Select the first cell in the row or column where you want to paste. Right-click that cell and then select Insert Copied Cells. And that copies over everything, including formatting, formulas, and everything else. And to move cells, if you're still counting the number of cells, going and inserting that number, coming back, copy and pasting, going back and deleting, come on. Try doing it this way instead. Select the entire row and then right-click the edge of your selected blue area. Keeping your right mouse depressed, you drag to where you want to move to, and then release your right mouse and select Shift down and move. Now, isn't that a whole lot easier than the way you used to move rows? Now, most people already know how to insert a comment, but in case you don't, let's do it quickly. Select the cell, right click, Insert Comment. Edit your comment, and it's as easy as that. Whenever anyone hovers over that cell, they will see your comment. And that's a standard feature of Excel that you can use in any Excel document. Now, this next feature you can use in any Excel document, but you have to have the Systems to Win add-in installed. Select the Systems to Win menu, and one of the special Systems to Win functions is the Copy Shapes feature that has all kinds of standard shapes that you can copy and paste into any Excel document. For example, you might use a burst to identify a problem, and of course you can format that any way you want it. And then you use a cloud when you have an idea for how to solve that problem, and when management says, that's a great idea, let's do it, you shade the cloud. And in addition to all those standard shapes, there's a user-defined section where you can store unlimited industry-specific shapes that will always be available to every one of your users in any Excel document, not just Systems to Win templates. Now, whenever you open any new Systems to Win template that you've never used before, you always want to look at the Excel tips most valuable for using this template, which is always a section on the Help worksheet. And once you learn how to use Google Site Search and Control F, you should be able to quickly find help for anything so you never get stuck using any Systems to Win template. And if you're smart, you're going to bookmark systemstowin.com in your smartphone so that you've always got answers not just to Excel questions, but to all those lean videos are always with you. So you should now be ready to go get some work done. And using the Systems to Win to-do list and other decision-making tools, you should be ready to get some prioritized work done.